Welcome to SJS Arts. So today I'm gonna choose a favorite film for every year I've been alive. So we are gonna start with 1997 and work our way up to the current point. Although I have to say I haven't seen any films from 2023 and I'm not sure when I'm gonna watch my first film from this new year. And 2022 is really bad for me as well. I think I've only seen like a couple of films from that year. And even 2021 hasn't been the best for me yet. I need to watch more recent films. Yeah, I just these days, again, I don't go to the cinema anymore and I don't rush to watch new films all the time. But yeah. But let's start with my year of birth. Again, I was born in 11th of March 1997, so my birthday is quite soon. But I think this year that I was born was pretty decent year for cinema. I mean, we even have one anime show, Berserk, which I really love. But let's talk about the films and pick my favorite of this year. So there are definitely few strong candidates here. This is one, this Finnish film, The Collector. Great film. And by the way, I didn't really think about this before starting this video. So I don't really know what I'm gonna pick yet. I mean, for a couple of the years, I definitely know, but not for all of them. And I actually did similar type of video like a few years ago, but again, early last year, I deleted my old videos and then I started again. So those videos don't exist anymore. And I've watched so many films since I did that original version anyway. So my opinion would be different anyway. But then another strong candidate is Kitano's Hanabi, probably my favorite Kitano film with Kikuchiro, and I'm sure Kikuchiro will come up in the 1999 part of this video. But then there are lots of also like really fun films here, like Air Force One, I remember really liking as a kid. As Good As It Gets has a great Nicholson performance. Really loved these as a kid. Okay, The Land Before Time films. Yeah. Face Off, I think, is a great action film. Carrier Girls is an underrated Mike Lee film. Really like this one. Taste of Cherry is definitely up there. But then we have a Lynch film, Lost Highway. So what should I actually pick? Because, again, I'm such a Lynch fanboy, so it's really hard to choose something else than Lynch, but I think I'll have to go with Hanabi. I think if I choose the best film of this year, it probably would be Taste of Cherry, but I think Hanabi, I have such a strong connection to it. Again, it kind of mixes all that Kitano does well, really well. Okay, so it has those spurts of violence, spurts of trauma, anxiety, but then it also has those beautiful moments with his painting-like cinematography and some great character moments and an insanely good ending as well. Yeah. So I think I'm gonna go with Hanabi, but I could have just as well gone with Taste of Cherry, Lost Highway, which is one of the great Lynch films. Again, I like talking in the phone, but I definitely wouldn't want the mystery man calling me, so yeah. And then The Collector again, great Finnish film. And then there are other good films here too. Oh fuck, I skipped the decade, unfortunately. I'll have to put the 1998. So this year I have no idea yet what I'm gonna pick. Nothing comes to mind yet. Oh well, now I know what I'm gonna pick, but let's give a shout out to a few films before I pick it. So, where should we start? Well, Koreeda's Afterlife, I saw this in the cinema. Absolutely beautiful film. If you want to talk about pure entertainment, this version of The Parent Trap is really, really funny. Lethal Weapon 4, I think many people just like maybe the first two Lethal Weapon films, but I really like the third and fourth one as well. really love when Danny Glover and Mel Gibson are fighting Jet Li. That's like a really badass scene. The first Pokemon film. So nostalgic for me. Buffalo 66, I think, is amazing. Oh, now I see happiness here. Like one of the most awkward and brilliant films ever, I think. Again, breaking all sorts of taboos, but in a really funny way. But you really have to have a dark sense of humor and awkward sense of humor to get this one. Crystal of My Car is an incredible film by Alexi German. History du cinéma. So I think this is the complete version. So yeah, great stuff. Eternity and a Day, one of Angelopoulos' better films. Love this one of my favorites. This was a big favorite of mine as a kid. Quest for Camelot. I had this on VHS and I watched it all the time. But now I'll reveal my choice, and it's of course my favorite comedy. It's The Big Lebowski. Am I the only one who wishes shit about the rules? Market zero. I probably shouldn't do this quote because I just woke up and my mouth is still quite dry, so I probably shouldn't do those quotes that much, but yeah. Shut the fuck up, Donnie. Donnie, you're out of your element. This guy fucking walks. I've never been more certain about anything in my life. My buddy has died face down in the mug so that this fucking strumpet, this fucking whore, could waltz around town. Yeah. Yeah. But The Big Lebowski for 1998. But now, have to go with 1999, so... Sorry, I just got some message. I was a bit carried away there. Well, I put my phone away for a bit so that it won't bother me. But yeah, this actually seems like a hard year at the moment. So we have Oshima's Taboo. I really love this one. I think it's maybe a bit underrated. Not many people talk about it. Although it might be the lack of accessibility. Again, it doesn't have a Blu-ray in the European region or the American region, I think. So that probably affects it. And don't really think it's streaming anywhere either, so. But yeah, hopefully it will get like a better release. I quite like this poster as well. Yeah. Gemini by Tsukamoto, another great, very unique Japanese film, just like Taboo is. Magnolia is like top tier BTA. I really love Peppermint Candy, and this has one of my favorite scores of all time. I listen to it a lot. I mean, I haven't listened to it lately, but overall I've listened to it like shit tons. One of my big childhood favorites, and I've watched it a couple of times as an adult too, is this Martin Lawrence film, Blue Streak, which is about this criminal who is after this diamond, and then he goes to jail, and then after he comes out of the jail, he becomes a police officer and he wants to track down that diamond that he hide away. But the building where he hide it away for it became the police station, so that's why he has to become a police officer. But it's so much fun. I mean, it's a fucking awful film basically, but it's just so bad it's good type of thing, yeah. Putravai, The Wind Will Carry Us, great films, but I'm a cheerleader, really love this film, can relate to it quite a lot. And it's really a Wes Anderson type of film, but I like this more than any Wes Anderson film, so. Eyes Wide Shut has gotten better for me as time has passed. Again, and I feel like it will become more and more of a classic. Kikujiro is definitely a strong candidate here. Straight Story is a really good Lynch film, but not one of my favorites. There's the fast food kung fu film. Three Kings. I remember this used to be on TV like always, and yeah. Yeah, I remember watching it on TV. It's fine, not really good. I mean, this isn't like the best year of cinema history, but there are a few really good films here. I think I'll have to go with another Kitano film, unfortunately. I mean, it's annoying to kind of pick from the same directors all the time, but yeah, I just love this film to death. It's so heartwarming. It's so beautiful. Again, another stunning score as well. Again, beautifully shot. The relationship is beautiful. Great performances, both from the kid and from Kitano himself. And yeah, such a great film. But probably the runner-up is Taboo because I do really love that film. Yeah. But yeah, now we go into the 2000s. Well, this is a great movie. I was really sad as a kid that I didn't have this on VHS because this was probably my favorite Pokemon film. Yeah, Mewtwo Returns. Now I want to watch it. I've actually talked about Pokemon with my friend lately, so it's kind of been on my mind anyway, so. Where should we start? Well, Joint Security Area is one of my favorite films. Again, a great Park Chan-wook film. Then we have Platform by Chia Shang-kei. Great film. Probably mispronounced his name, by the way. Sorry about that. Pokemon 3 with Charizard and Entei and everything has its moments, but I think it has some like really boring moments as well and stupid moments. Werkmeister Harmonies is really good. Yi Yi is a masterpiece. Love American Psycho. The Isle is one of my favorites, or close to being a favorite. The Digimon movie, I really love Digimon, by the way. But I always liked the series more than the movie. But I watched that movie probably like 20 times when I was a kid. I even had it like two VHS copies of it or something. Yeah. This I liked more than the Toy Story films, Buzz Lightyear. Yeah. But I think if I had to go with one movie, I'm gonna go with Yi Yi. Again, it's like the. It could be like the best kind of slice of life drama ever made. It's so good. So good. Again, it's utterly gorgeous, like visually. Like, it's. That's like the absolute, like, perfect cinematography to me. Like, those beautiful still shots and not much movement, but it's also calm and beautiful and wide. I just really love that. But the runner-ups would be American Psycho and JSA. Yeah. Again, this wasn't like the best year of cinema history either, but there are some good films there. Oh, I forgot to mention Eureka, by the way. This is another masterpiece. Love this film and definitely want to give it a shout out here, but yeah, I'm still gonna pick Yi Yi. 2001, I already know what I'm gonna pick here, and you probably know it as well. Kate and Leopold is quite fun. I really like the premise. Yeah. And we really need more of these types of films where like character travels from like a distant past to current day and has to struggle with the new technology and stuff. Like, I think that's a great premise, but it isn't done that often, and when it's done, people don't do it well. But I think Kate and Leopold was pretty good. Yeah. Well, this is a top-tier film. This is by Greek director Antoinette Angelidi, T4 Reality. So that's definitely up there for me. Then we have, well, Legally Blonde, I think, is a really fun rom-com. Yeah. Training Day I've always liked. Especially when we have, like, Ethan Hawke doing coke. Or was it heroin? I think it's coke. And then when Denzel Washington is howling like a wolf, and that stuff I laughed so much as a kid. Millennium Mambo is definitely in the conversation. Fat Girl is definitely in the conversation. Piano Teacher is in the conversation. And this is quite interesting. Godard film, In Praise of Love. What Time Is It There is great. Chiming Liang film. But I of course have to go with the outro to my videos, which is Don't Drink All the Coke. So it's Mulholland Drive. my second favorite movie of all time. Again, there are three Lynch films in my top 10, so that kind of shows how much of a fan I am. But this, to me, again, if it wasn't for Fire Walk With Me, this would be my favorite film of all time. Again, and this was for a while my favorite film of all time, but yeah, this just does everything that Lynch does well, again, to the 110%. Again, the two lead actresses are beautiful, they give great performances. Again, this has that dreamy fantasy like atmosphere to it, but then in the end it crushes your expectations and it hits you in the face really hard, and I still cannot get over the ending. Like, it really fucks me up every time I watch it, and the last couple of times I watched this film it was late at night, and it's not a good idea to watch this late at night. Yeah, and there are so many beautiful moments here and lots of funny moments, like with the cowboy and this is the girl. I really love that. Really love the audition scene as well, and the scene where they are in the kind of conference table and they say to Justin Theroux for the first time that this is the girl, that you have to say that. Like, that scene is so great. But yeah, I have to go with Mulholland Drive. Okay, yeah. Then 2002, I have no idea what I'm gonna pick here yet, but I mean, I have one idea, but we'll see. Uzak is a great Ceylan film. I highly recommend that one. This is one of my favorite guilty pleasures. Like Mike, again, I love basketball, and this is a great basketball movie. So much fun. Used to be a huge fan of 8 Mile when I was a kid. Again, I don't really like Eminem that much anymore. I like other type of hip hop more, but 8 Mile is still a fine film. Not great, but pretty good. Oasis is definitely in the conversation. Rush and Ark is a great film. Irreversible has like probably like one of the most disturbing scenes I've ever seen. It's the like 5 minute long rape scene. Like, that was so hard to watch. Like, there has never been another scene that's been harder to watch than that. Yeah, and I watched this film with a friend and it was so awkward as well, so yeah. Punch Drunk Love is definitely in the conversation. Again, love this film. Then The Man Without a Past is one of my favorite Kaurismäki films. Chapon is a great Ray Kadas film. The Scorpion King was one of my childhood favorites. Fucking Scorpion King. Hero, I think, is a beautiful film as well. This Pokemon film, I really don't remember much about. I think I only saw this once. This is a pretty good Claire Denis film. But I think I'm gonna go with... I'm gonna go with Punch Drunk Love. Again, this is my favorite PTA film. I think it's a beautiful, kind of more low-key film. Adam Sandler is so good in it. Very layered character. And yeah, it's also very funny. It's very awkward. Yeah, it's a great film. 2003. Maybe we have to speed this up a bit. Memories of Murder is definitely up there. The Return is up there. This is definitely up there. Spring, Summer, Fall, Winter and Spring. Well, if we counted concert films, this would be up there. Lamentations by Opeth. Matchstick Men is actually really funny. Freddy vs. Jason was one of my favorite films as a kid. History de Marie and Julien. Great Jacques Rivette film, but not one of his best. Because his best are like the best films of all time, so Goodbye Dragon Inn. But I think what should I go with? Well, it's between The Return and Spring, Summer, Fall, Winter and Spring, but I'm gonna go with The Return. I think this really blew me away. It's it's very ambiguous film. It's very slow built film. It has this very well built out tension to it. Has quite of a shocking ending as well. A beautiful cinematography, and yeah, this is like might be the, like the best like more modern Russian film. Although I haven't seen that many in the end, but yeah. And shout out to the Bionicle film, yeah, 2004. Well, through Three Iron is probably gonna be the film, unless there is something like really amazing here, because that's one of my top 50 films of all time. Mean Girls is fun. Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind is great. The Weeping Meadow is up there. Nobody Knows is another favorite of mine. This I really enjoy. 13 Going on 30. It's kind of like Big with Tom Hanks, but a female version of that. This I really loved as a in my early teens. This is the Rock, Dwayne Johnson version of the Walking Tall thing. And this I watched all over and over again. I've actually been meaning to watch this again because I haven't seen it in a very long time. But as a like young teenager, I really loved this film, and it really was kind of a comfort movie to me. Let me know if you have seen that one. Again, nobody talks about it, but 2046 is great. Tropical My Lady is great. Love the Garfield movie. Action Man movie. Like me and my friend when we were kids, like we watched this like every day. Like this was so good. Action Man Robot Attack. Like I need to watch this again and make a review for it. Yeah. I mean, it's so awful, like, but we just laughed it, like, it has absolutely awful animation, but the King Arthur movie, the staple of all the DVD bargain bins back in the day. But I'm gonna go with Three Iron again. This has a beautiful soundtrack, two beautiful quiet performances. I love these unconventional love stories. Again, this was shot in like 3 weeks, but it's like one of the most beautiful films ever made. And yeah, this is Kim Ki-duk at his best, and to me this is, again, this is my favorite South Korean film of all time, and it would take a pretty fucking huge effort to that somebody would dethrone this. That's my favorite South Korean film, because this is like top 50, maybe even top 30 film for me, like absolutely one of the best of the 21st century. Then 2005, Strange Circus, Get Rich or Die Trying was one of my favorite films as a kid. Protector I really loved as a kid. Everybody was talking about Sahara when I was a kid. Coach Carter is fun, basketball movie. This is a great Finnish movie. Bittersweet Life is up there. Three Times is a great Hao Xiaoshen film. This is actually hard here. I'm not sure whether there are any like films on my favorites list here. I don't think so, actually. Oh, Bittersweet Life is the only one that is on my favorites list, so it's obvious that I'm gonna go with that one then. Again, really fun, very stylistic, nihilistic, dark South Korean film. Yeah, great stuff. Okay, Cache is great too. If you are not with me, then you are my enemy. 2006. Yeah, I think these years of like the mid-2000s were like pretty poor for cinema. Well, there we have Covenant. Harry Potter can't kiss my ass. Dreamcatcher. That was the shit. Oh, The Prestige is so underrated. What am I gonna choose here? Like, don't see anything that I like absolutely love here. Well, I guess I have to go with Pan's Labyrinth, which is a film I really, really like, but it's not like favorite of mine, but it's like a really good film. So I think I'm gonna go with Pan's Labyrinth, because this seems like this was like an awful year for cinema, basically. So yeah, gonna go with this one. Great fairy tale, but I give a shout out to the second Garfield film. This is really funny. Trousers. Inland Empire. Yeah, that's one Lynch film that I'm not gonna go with, so yeah. 2007. Have a memory that this wasn't like the best year either. Although, well, there was no Country for Old Men, so there's at least one great film here. Well, yeah, that's like the obvious choice for me. Oh, Secret Sunshine I do really love as well. That's one of my favorites. And The Banishment is great, but I'm gonna go with No Country for Old Men. To me, after The Big Lebowski, this is the best Coen Brothers film, and this is probably their best looking film as well, and it looks absolutely beautiful. Again, top tier performances, great way to build tension, great dialogue as well, and lots of interesting themes as well about kind of different extremes and then shades of grey and stuff like that, again represented by the different type of characters. So yeah, 2008 Far Cry movie, loved this as a kid. It's like absolute dog shit, but yeah, this doesn't look like a good year either. Jumper was something that I watched as a kid as well. So again, these are the years that I lived as a kid, so Never Back Down, fucking love this movie. A great kind of MMA, stupid like teen drama. Forbidden Kingdom, if you want to see Jackie Chan and Jet Li fighting each other, watch this. Bangkok Dangerous, if you want to see Nicolas Cage eating hot Thai food and making weird faces, I think you would love this movie. Like, I've watched this like 10 times at least. Still Walking, probably have to go with that one. Oh, Dear Zachary is like a really great film. But I'm gonna go with Still Walking, it's one of my favorite Koreedas. Okay, kind of that perfect, quiet, calm family drama, yeah. Shout out to Sunnyside in New York as well. Oh, the 24 film, yeah. Oh, I have to change my choice. I didn't see Love Exposure here, but this is one of my top 50 films of all time, so I have to go with this one. One of the most insane films ever made. So much fun. So much fun. 2009. Okay, I'm just seeing lots of shitty Hollywood movies, so Cafe Noir is a great Korean film. It's on YouTube if you want to watch it. Mecha Shark versus Giant Octopus, fun film. I Killed My Mother, this is up there. Blood and Bone, I used to love. Okay, Michael J. White is badass. Confessions of a Shopaholic, really fun film. And there's a connection to Finland there, which is really weird. Bong Joon-ho's Mother is great. But yeah, so Dragon Ball Evolution is an atrocious film. I love Dragon Ball, but that didn't do it well. So what am I gonna go with? I think I Killed My Mother seems to be the only favorite of mine from this year, so I'm gonna go with it. Again, it's the first feature film of Xavier Dolan. I can relate to some aspects of this film, so that's why I love it. And it's so well written and very impressive film considering how young Xavier Dolan was when this was done. And yeah, love this film to death. Then the next decade, we're starting with 2010. Well, I'm sure that I'm gonna pick Inception. From Paris with Love is great. Wax on, wax off. Mike Lee's Another Year is really good. The Kids Are Alright is like nice kind of indie queer film, so yeah. This is like pretty awful, I think. Year, I don't think there are any of my favorites here. Well, there are a couple of near favorites, so Goldfish, I think, is one that could become a favorite, and I do really love it. Then I Saw the Devil is really good. Certified Copy, Uncle Boomy. But I'm gonna go with Goldfish. Okay, and another Sion Sono film, but this one I really love. It's about this fucked up serial killer and another person who becomes a serial killer, if I remember correctly. And but yeah, it's full of dark humor and fucked up stuff, so I do love it. And then let's give a shout out to Poetry by Lee Chang-dong, great film. Born to Raise Hell, Steven Seagal in Romania. 2011, I think this is a great year for cinema actually, like might be the best from 2010s. So we have Kotoko, that's definitely a strong candidate immediately. Once Upon a Time in Anatolia is great, Drive is great. Pariah is really good. Weekend is one of my favorites, Tree of Life is one of my favorites. Born to Race was one of my favorites as a young teenager. I think I rewatched it as an adult as well. But Our Shame is great. Never Back Down 2 is really good. Intouchables was the first French film I watched and I loved it to death back then. But John Cena. I'm gonna go with Kotoko. Like this absolutely crushed me. It's like one of the best explorations of mental illness ever in film, I think. And even the cinematography. Like does a great is a like great way to explore mental illness in this film. Like it does, it has all those kind of quick cuts and lots of camera movement that kind of showcases the schizophrenia that this character is going through and stuff. So it's a brilliant film. Again, I could have explained that way better, but yeah. Oh, there was the Ghost Rider sequel there as well. And this year, The Act of Killing, shout out to that. Nicolas Cage in Stolen. Like Someone in Love is great film. I think I have to go with Lawrence anyways, another Xavier Dolan film. Okay, this is an absolute emotional powerhouse. Like this has like triumphant scenes, it has very sad scenes, it has very beautiful scenes, great soundtrack, great cinematography, great characters, lots of great character moments, lots of great relationship moments. I love this film to death. Go watch it if you haven't already. 2013. What should I call it in here? Well, Like Father, Like Son is the runner-up, but I'm gonna go with Why Don't You Play in Hell, which is another top 50 favorite of mine. This is already the third Sono film that I'm gonna go with, so sorry about that, but I just cannot choose anything else than this, because this is one that I love to death. I've seen it 3 times now, and it's just so much fun. It's all about what makes cinema great. It kind of talks about kind of the relationship of real life and art as well. And yeah, it's a beautifully funny film. Yeah. 2014. Well, now the amount of films got like smaller, so it's a bit easier to choose. But here it's one obvious choice for me, which is one of my top 5 films of the 21st century, and it's Whiplash. I've seen this so many times. Again, I'm a huge fan of jazz music, and one of the reasons I kind of got interested in jazz music was Whiplash, so I'm kind of really thankful for it, for that as well. But as a film also, it's really good. Again, J.K. Simmons gives one of my favorite performances of all time. He's such a dick. I kind of had similar type of teacher in elementary school, actually, who was an ex-soldier and stuff, so he had that trauma and stuff, and but yeah, so I can kind of relate to this as well. But it's such a fun film, and beautiful film, beautiful ending. Yeah. 2015. Well, I'm gonna go with The Lobster. This is another top 50 film of all time to me, and yeah, this is again all about communication, all about modern relationships. This has some of the best dark humor I've ever seen, and again, Colin Farrell gives absolutely stunning performance in this one. It's beautifully shot, very entertaining, very fucked up, very creative, very unique. Love this film. But then Love and Peace is a runner-up. Tokyo rimpikuni mukete, kono kuni wa, don don, yutaka ni natte ky. Teko no. Yeah, there's some Japanese for you. Yeah. Then The Whispering Star, another great Sono film. Anomalisa is really good. Rest in peace Kobe Bryant, he was the guy who got me into basketball, and I've been Lakers fan since 2012, so yeah. Now the Love and Peace song is just stuck in my head. Pikado no mae o vasurenai. This was so disappointing, the sequel series to Gilmore Girls, which is one of my top three favorite TV shows of all time, but this one was pretty good, but yeah, I don't always watch it after I watch Gilmore Girls, so yeah. I probably have to go with, again, this isn't the best year for cinema. Yeah, there are two choices. Oh man, Your Name. I give a shout out to that. And Our Handmaiden is one of my favorites. Yeah, I actually have to go with Handmaiden. I didn't see it immediately. I was gonna go with Moonlight or Anti-Porno, but I'm gonna go with Handmaiden. It's a great Park Chan-wook film. Okay, beautifully constructed, beautifully looking film. Can be quite fucked up in places, and great performances, great characters. Yeah, such a great film. Interesting structure. 2017, I remember being pretty good year for cinema. Columbus, shout out to that. This quite a good gay film, God's Own Country. Yeah, The Other Side of Hope is one of my favorites. I think people probably know what I'm gonna go with already, but The Killing of a Sacred Deer, really good. Yorgos Lanthimos film, but ultimately I have to go with Twin Peaks The Return. sorry about that. Yeah, again, Fire Walk With Me is my favorite Twin Peaks installment, but I really love The Return and as well as the original series, so yeah, this is absolute perfection. Again, it's the top 3 film of the 21st century, if not top 1. It's that level of good. It has so many funny sequences, so many scary sequences, so many sequences in between. Again, Kyle MacLachlan is so good in this, both as Dale Cooper, but also as the doppelganger and as Ducky. Yeah, what a performance. 2018, we are closing to the end. Well, there's Love, Simon. Again, every time I see that poster now, I'm filled with emotion. Yeah. Elephant Sitting Still is brilliant. The Miseducation of Cameron Post, very relatable, as was Love, Simon. This one I really love, Dragon Ball Super Broly. I think this is the best Dragon Ball film ever made. Yeah, but I think the series are still way better. Yeah. The Favorite is a great Yorgos Lanthimos film. Again, it shows the stupidity of the Oscars that they picked this as a fucking best picture winner. But I still like enjoyed it, but overall it's not a great film. But I'm gonna go with Burning, I think, because this is an absolutely stunning Lee Chang-dong film. Again, if you want to learn about how to use symbolism in a film, I think this is one that you should watch. There's lots of that in here, and great performances, great kind of slow build up to the end. Lots of ambiguity there, which I like. Yeah, brilliant film. 2019. We have Dogs Don't Wear Pants. This is a really good Finnish film. Parasite. I do really join the hype with everybody. It's a brilliant film. The Forest of Love, I love, but I love the extended cut more, so which is basically from the next decade, although I think it was obviously shot in 2019, I think, or 18. But yeah, I'm gonna be boring and go with Parasite. Again, so much fun. I had such a good time in the cinema with this one. Yeah, brilliantly shot. Again, it's a great kind of mix of different genres of, again, thriller, drama, comedy, even horror. Yeah, but let's go to 2020. So now the last few years should be very easy. Yeah, you can see I haven't seen that many, so. Well, I'm not gonna go with the deep cut. I mean, it's my favorite out of these, but because it was basically from the previous decade, I'm not gonna go with that one. So I'm gonna go with, no, this is actually, again, these are like good films, but they didn't like speak to me that highly. So it's really hard to pick one. I'm gonna go with Minari. I think it's, again, it was really well made, slice of life. Drama, again, not very unique, but very well made and enjoyable and touching film. So I'm gonna go with it, with that one. 2021, I'm gonna go with, this is actually a great documentary that not enough people talk about, Papi Jar context. This was a good Finnish film, this was good. But I'm gonna go with The Green Knight. Really good Seventh Seal-esque film, and again I love the Arthurian myths. I haven't read the books and stuff, but I do like enjoy them in a casual way, and I want to read the books and stories someday. Yeah, but The Green Knight was amazingly shot, beautiful, kind of awkward in a good way at places, because the performances were quite awkward, and lots of things to like here. 2022, yeah. Well, I'm gonna go with Dragon Ball Super Superhero, which I enjoyed quite a bit. Again, it has that new animation style and stuff, so it's quite different from previous Dragon Ball stuff, but I did enjoy it, even though, again, this highlighted Gohan and Piccolo, like both of the characters, but I'm definitely more of a Vegeta version and also Goku version, but this was fun. But anyway, let me know your choices. And if you want to do like a response video, that's welcome as well. And I try to do a video where I talk about all the favorite films from years that happened before I was born and stuff. But anyway, thanks for watching. Don't drink all the Coke, and ciao.